Hey, my amazing noodles. Welcome back to part four of Soul Reaver. So the story so far, we have killed two of the brothers, so that's Melkaya and Zephon, and we've had a first confrontation with Cain. Before I continue with the story, I'm going to collect a couple of items. In the last video, I used the warp gate to go to the human citadel, and that's where I am right now. So, exploring. Finding where we are. We've come out of the warp gate area. Take a right here. This is actually kind of a circular area, so you will just keep going round and round if you don't know where you're going. We can come in this water. It won't harm you. It's just a bit of water, so you're not going to be completely submerged. So it won't do any harm. And here is another health piece. A lisp. And now we're going to go collect a new item, so glide over to here. And we've got a tricky set of jumps now. We're going to be gliding between these arches. So do your best. Sometimes he decides not to glide. Okay. So from here, just go over to. Yep, there we go, this ledge. And you've got this switch. So we're going to get a completely new item, which is an energy upgrade. So that's, if I pause the game, you've got your blue sparklies in the corner. That will increase the energy of the blue sparklies. So we can get these couple of items here now because we've got the new ability from Zephyr. We can now climb up walls. Because Raziel obviously didn't know how to do that. So coming in straight down, follow the path. Here we are.
With this artifact, your glyph energy capacity is increased.
And there was one occasion, just once, I couldn't grab this. You actually just literally walk into it. But I couldn't pick it up. He wasn't acknowledging that it was there. So I got angry and I attacked it. And that worked. That worked. So if you're having trouble, just try new things. Try attacking it. See what happens. But now I've got those two items. I'm a little bit lost. Find the warp gate. Here we are. Nope, that is not the warp gate. My goodness. But yes, find the warp gate, and I'm going to continue with the story once I get there. Here it is, up the stairs. But you know it's up the stairs. So we want to go to the Sanctuary of the Clans. That's what the voice of the Elder God told us after we had defeated Zephon. So the quickest route to the Sanctuary of the Clans is the Lake of the Dead warp gate. So when you come out of here, you just want to take a right when you get through the door. There we are. Too many windy passages and not enough words to speak between walking. Words and stuff. So take a right when you exit. And this is where we want to be. This is the Sanctuary of the Clans. So don't forget, you have to shift to be able to enter. So I'll probably just speed this up. We're heading to the main room, so we know where we're going. We've been there before. Not gonna bother to shift because we've got all the gates. Here we are. So inside here is a ladder that we wouldn't have been able to use before. Here we go. And don't forget, if you come in here and you have no idea what to do, You can stand on the circle in the middle of the floor, and Ariel will give you a hint, though she won't actually tell you there's a ladder there. You have to figure that out for yourself. So I'm going to hug the wall because I love walls. And I dislike falling. So, wall hugging. So you've got two doors here, right and left. I always choose to go left. No reason, really. They both lead to the same place. But it really doesn't matter. Hop straight on down. And you really are just following the path at the moment. There's no fork, you're just following the path and then you'll eventually get a cutscene.
The ancient tomb of the Seraphim, once impenetrably sealed, now ravaged by Nosgoth's upheavals, its mysteries lay exposed. In the time of Vorador, centuries before Cain was made, the Seraphim warrior priests waged a merciless war against the vampire tribes of Nosgoth. Emboldened by righteousness, they committed unspeakable and indiscriminate acts of violence, massacring fledglings and ancients alike. They decimated entire bloodlines in mere decades. Now their husks lay here, murderers enshrined.
Okay, so before I enter that area, just going to come to this side, there is a warp gate. I never use this warp gate, but I'll activate it just for the sake of the walkthrough. And if you want, you can activate it and then go and do a load of new stuff. And, well, this is where you can warp straight back to. If you want to pick up items, go and do that. But I won't. I'm here, so I will continue along the path. So the symbol on the wall there is very similar to the human citadel, and I do sometimes mix them up. So don't worry if you mix them up, it's easily done. Excuse me. So now we want to come inside, so shift.
Take heed, Raziel. A forgotten history lies within. Know thyself, though it may destroy you.
So what could be inside? Make this guy jump. Oh, he didn't jump. I find it funny when they jump. So yeah, always use a portal if there's one there, because it's easier to shift back to the spectral realm than it is to find a portal and shift to the material realm. So here you've got this block, so just grab this and pull it out.
As I pulled the stone free, a sigh of sepulchral air escaped the inner chamber. I was not prepared for what lay beyond this threshold. These crypts, defiled caskets of Seraphim saints, bearing my brother's names and my own. The irony of Cain's blasphemous act rushed in on me with the crushing force of revelation. Were my hands not as bloody as these? Worse, I had spilled the blood of my brothers, these very comrades whose tombs lay ravaged before me.
Yes, Raziel, you were Seraphon, born of the same force that all but destroyed your race. Before the dawn of the Empire, you were chosen. Cain, Nosgoth's solitary self-declared monarch, plundered this tomb and raised you from these crypts. Breathing his vampiric gift into your defiled corpses, he resurrected you as his favored sons.
So that's one hell of a plot twist right there. So, crazy stuff. So we're actually at a bit of a dead end now, but if you notice the swirly whirly on the ground, you might take that as a hint, and we want to shift. That's exactly what we want to do. Awesome. So in this next area, once I come through the gate, there is a wraith, and he is a pain in the bum. Oh, he tried to swipe me. But don't forget, the wraiths, once they hit you, they start draining your health. So just be aware of that. And here is the portal. And once you shift, you'll get a cutscene.
Heretic, you shall not pass.
Such loyalty to one who has you guarding this outpost like a chained dog. Do you prosper on the scraps he casts you?
Your insults will do nothing to blunt the agonies of your demise.
Cain killed me once. Behold the result. I have no more to fear from you.
Okay, so you don't want to linger there for too long because he shoots a projectile. Oh, yeah, try not to just run straight into the water as well. Oh, here he comes. Go away. Okay. So, once you shift, always be prepared to get out of the way really quick. Oh, he got me. So I've lost my Reaver. And if you don't have your Reaver, just throw him in the water.
This relic has infused you with a power to compress and manipulate space. As your symbiotic weapon, the Soul Reaver is also thus enhanced. You may focus and project an orb of kinetic energy to strike objects that are otherwise beyond your reach.
So that guy actually has a name. He has an official name. His name is Morlock, and he's kind of a tribute to the brother that we actually don't get to kill in this game. It skips one of the brothers in this game. I think it was a time issue. They didn't have time to put it in. But we've got a new ability from him. You can shoot projectiles, so that's awesome. And if you lose your Reaver, you can still shoot the projectiles. They're actually a little bit slower, but that is not a problem. So anything like what Raziel's standing on, like a target, like what I've just shot, there's a block there you need to hit it twice, so you can just use it to push things or break things, so that's cool. So hop inside, there is an enemy behind Raziel, but just ignore him, just cuz. Into the water. And at this point now you've got your new ability, your projectile, you can actually leave the area and go and do other stuff. And then you come back this way. But, seeing as though I'm already here, this is actually the path to another brother, another boss. So I'm just gonna go ahead and continue along the path. Also, before we get to the dungeon, or the lair, whatever you want to call it, there is another warp gate, so you can make your way to that warp gate and then go and collect all your stuff, and you've got a closer warp gate to the boss to come back to. So on that ledge there is a block, so just use your new projectile to shove that out the way. There you go. And through this doorway, if you go straight on, you'll come to a dead end. All that is that way is the glyph energy, a top up to put it right back up to full. But you actually want to come this way, and it's very easy to miss. I've done it many, many times. So don't be confused when you get to the dead end. You missed the turn off. So this bit here is a bit tedious. So also you can use your projectile to inflict damage to enemies, so that's cool. And right here you see there's a block behind the bars in front of Raziel. You want to hit that with your projectile because you want to climb up onto it to reach that doorway there. But there are two enemies. They are the ones that we've killed to get the projectile. I believe they're called Turelim or Turelim, and they're very mean. So as soon as you shift, you want to immediately try and jab at your projectile button. Go away. I think I got it. Let's have a look. So shift back again, and then you can make your way through the bars. So those enemies are pretty quick as well. They take a lot of health off and they're pretty fast. So there's quite a few of those around in the area. Here we are. There's a portal there, but I won't use it because we actually need to be in the spectral realm. So glide across. There's water there, so be careful you don't fall into it. You want to land on the boat. And if you are not in the spectral realm, you can't reach this ledge here. So you need to be in the spectral realm to hop up, because otherwise the boat is too far away from the ledge. So that's why I didn't bother to shift just there. Okay, so here, bear with me, I'm all tangled in my wires. There we go. That doorway there leads to the next boss. His name is Rahab. And we've got this warp gate here. So, now is the time. If you want to wander off and get items, you can do that and come straight back to this spot. I won't know. I will continue with the boss. I don't know why all the corridors are so long in this game. It is unnecessary. So this boss is possibly the easiest to kill, but the hardest to get to. So this one will have much rage. So you see straight in front of Raziel there's a door with like a target on it. So just shoot that and it will open. Unfortunately, it closes behind him.
Once a sanctuary against the vampire menace, this abbey has been drowned by the deluge spilling from this wounded land. Your brother Rahab and his brood, devastated even by the feeble rays of Nazgoth's sun, overcame their vulnerability to water and retreated from the surface. Now they haunt these ruins and glide in the darkness of its stagnant depths.
So this is the point of no return, because that door is closed. If you do want to leave the area, you are actually going to have to save your game and quit the game so that you end up back in the underworld. So let's do our best here, because wow, look at all the water. This is not an easy area. This isn't even the annoying bit. So these enemies also shoot projectiles, and in this area in particular, if they just happen to jump onto one of these blocks to try and attack you, they will instantly burn up, which is quite amusing. We've got an enemy straight ahead, so use your Reaver. It stops his projectile, and this guy can be a bit tricky, but I managed to push him onto the spike quite easily. I'm not going to eat his soul, because that means now he'll stay there forever and won't respawn. So I'm going to ignore most of the enemies, just because it's me. I'll shoot him, there you go. Gruesome. So, enemy round the corner. Careful of him, he's annoying. But you're heading straight forward to this gate. So sometimes if you do attack the enemies, you end up just losing more health than it's worth, which is one of the main reasons I ignore them. It's just to preserve health and get on with the game. So just sneak right up to the edge here. So this bit can be tedious, it's not too difficult. Oh, thought I was gonna fall. So you can just see there's a guy across the way, so let's just hope he misses you. Awesome, so ignore him as well. Just got. What? Nice. So it's pretty simple in terms of where to get to. You know what to do here, there is a blatant path to follow, but it's this next part that is difficult. So you will see why in a moment. Let me just hit some of these guys so I can grab a soul. Come on. There you go. Okay. So you want to come over to here, so coming through the passageway into this room, you'll take a right. I'll look again. And here's the portal. And you are actually right next to the water. So don't forget, these enemies are in the water. So as soon as you shift, you want to hop onto that ladder. Climb up and then come to the side. And sometimes the enemies have actually glitched onto the beams, which is annoying because you can't climb the ladder because they're shooting at you. So the ledge where I was on, where the portal was, you have to either stand on that, or there's another ledge on the opposite side down below, and you just have to do your best and try and shoot projectiles. It can be annoying. But this is the difficult part. You have to glide to the beams, but the beams are at a distance where it's too close for a higher glide, and I believe it's too far away for a lower glide. But you're better off doing a higher glide, because you do have more control over Raziel. I think I've said that many times. So even if it was close enough for a lower glide, I would probably opt for a higher glide. And you wanted to sort of, what I do is I take the long way around. Oh, failed already. Good start. So you kind of go around and take a long route just to... I know it's not making sense. I know that. I didn't get a soul. Too far away. I most likely will just speed a lot of this up, especially if I'm failing. Because after the beams, there are another set of beams. And if you fall off the second one, you have to start the first ones again. Could you grab that? Thanks. You don't want to linger on that spot. So last time I practiced this, I had a lot of trouble. So you kind of want to take the long way. Oh no, I failed again. Whoa. Be here a while, I can tell. That was close. Okay. So I come all the way to one side and ignore that. Start. So you see, I'm kind of looping. Ooh, nearly fell. Taking a long way, kind of. Is that making sense? Anyway, here we go. And you don't have enemies, so be careful. Just a couple of them come round, and you got me. You want to shoot a projectile at this glass, and now you've got these beams. Possibly not as hard. So I do a normal jump and glide. I don't do a... No! I don't do a higher glide. So I will go all the way back round. Try again. How far that projectile got over there. Usually I don't think they go that far. So you can only do your best. Yeah. Awesome. Made it. And then just sneak, sneak, sneak to the edge, because you don't want to fall off. Not at this point. I've done it before. And I was most upset. Oh my god. Alright, that's alright. I'll do it again. Okay, so it appears I jinxed myself right there. Jinxed is what I meant to say. So if you fall off here, that's actually where you started, and you have to do the whole thing again. So let's not fall off again. because I also fell off these beams again since trying to come back and do the entire dungeon again. So you just want to glide onto this larger section, and you're coming over to here. I'm going to sneak because I really don't want to fall off. So you're looking for that chain that's hanging. That's where you're aiming for. And you want to interact with the chain. Okay, so that door that opened is right at the bottom of these stairs. And the stairs are very crazy in this game. But, and there's water, so don't be alarmed. It's not very noticeable. Okay. This is the boss room. We have to hop onto these pillars, hop along until we find the portal. So it is a lot easier to use your higher glide. For the PlayStation you press L1 to get down like that. I find it easier for these pillars, and it's easier to know when you need to let go of the glide, and he'll just drop straight onto the pillar. Okay, so when we shift, the boss will be here. This will be Rahab, and before I shift, I will just explain to you, because something that wasn't explained in the tutorial, the training area, and it's a reason why I got very, very stuck on this when I very first played it. So on the PlayStation version, you can press L2 and R2 to move the camera angle, and if you press them both together, it looks forward and you can actually look around. And now you've got your new projectile, you can hold that down, and when you release, you shoot a projectile. So we're actually aiming for these little tiny windows, these little coloured windows. We want to break them, and that's how we defeat the boss. So you can tap your projectile button, or you can hold it and then let go. So that's what we're doing here. I'm just explaining that to you because it was not in the tutorial, and this one is very difficult if you don't know how to look around. It's a bit of a bummer.
Rahab, you have adapted well to your environment, for one so maladjusted.
Do not mock me, Raziel. You of all of us should respect the power bestowed by a limitation overcome. Cain said you would come.
You speak with the murderer?
You would do well to mind your blasphemous tongue.
What more did he tell you?
That you would destroy me.
I will indeed. But tell me, before I tear your soul from its moorings, do you know what we were before Cain spawned us?
Human.
Seraphan, Rahab. The antithesis of all we ever believed.
Does it matter? We were lost. He saved us.
Saved us? From what?
From ourselves.
Alright, so You get to shoot a couple of windows before... Oh, well, I was too slow. Before he shoots a projectile, I was wrong. So he's disappeared under the water, and if you time it right... Yes, that was good. There's no time to count, it's just when you think he might re-emerge. Whoops. Ooh. Oh, I've done it again. Ow. I thought he was actually going to disappear that time. So another point is you don't... Why do they keep shooting me? Usually he disappears under the water. Oh, well. He's not abiding by the rules of combat today. So one more window. There we go.
Soul, you have overcome your former vulnerability to water's touch. Immersion in water will no longer dissolve your physical body, enabling you to swim to areas heretofore beyond your reach.
Awesome. So, Raziel can finally go in the water and finally have a bath. Look at that. So it is pretty difficult to swim. Be able to get the hang of it. So when we get to the top of the stairs, the voice will speak to us yet again.
Beyond the maelstrom of the abyss, a subterranean tunnel leads northward to the clan territory of your brother, Dumar. Endowed with Rahab's soul, you may swim to gain entry where your progress was previously impeded.
Okay. So, to continue with the story, you would head over to Dumar. But first, I will actually not do that in this video. Also, don't forget the door that we came in is locked, so this is the area where we started in this area. Good words. And this is where I kept falling off. So to get out of this area, you want to come back into here. And there's a new move for a speed burst, so let's have a look. There we go. Quite cool. So I won't actually be doing a Dumar in the next video either. I will leave the next video just for picking up items and finding things we might need. So just be warned that the boss battle will not be in the next video. So here we are back in this main area where the beams were, so we can now swim in here. And yes, there are enemies. You want to shoot that window through here. Very sneaky. There are kind of things that look like balloons down in this area at the bottom of the stairs, and there are enemies in some of them, so be warned. So at the bottom of the stairs, you want to find another set of stairs. Here we are, through here. So I'm going down this set of stairs for an optional reason. There is a brand new thing in here. Follow it around and look for this window. So shoot that as well. And for this new thing, we need the Reaver. So just on the left there, that is so you can put your health back up to full so you can have the Reaver, and you want to come up to this fire and press the action button.
This elemental forge is tuned to the Soul Reaver's energy. Once baptized in this primordial flame, the blade may be imbued with fire at any future time.
So this is a forge. This one specifically is obviously the Fire Forge. Because it affects the Reaver, it affects your projectiles, so you can shoot fire, and it's very awesome. So that's the only one in this game, and in the other games there's a few more, but in this one they all got cut. And your glyphs that you collect would have been the same as the forges. And you can shoot projectiles corresponding to the forge. So I'm not too certain how it would work, because it's all been deleted, it never got into the actual game. But when you go into the water, it's extinguished, unfortunately. But whenever you find any flame, maybe not a torch hanging on a wall, I've never tried. But any flame, if you press action when you go up to it, you can get your Fire Reaver back. And it is one of the best things ever. So that's the only forge in the game that made it onto the game. So now, I think we come this way. Enemies, don't forget, so be careful. There's a lot of archways, and we're looking for one specific one. Here it is, that was actually really quick. That looks like it's got a beam of sunlight coming down from it. That's just a hint that that's the one to go through. So we are heading out of the water, we're just following the tunnels. And there's also kind of a sneaky hidden tunnel. It's not very well hidden. But there is also the fire glyph that I will go and find in the water. Very close by. Or here? Yes, we're here. So if you don't want it, just go up the stairs there. But coming out of that tunnel, take a right through here. And there are two ways of getting this fire glyph. If you have not been to the Fire Forge and endowed the Reaver with fire, you'll need a torch just on the wall here. So I will take that up with me. So we've got a gate that we can phase through there, and we have a corridor, and we have a doorway. So, got to remember what to do now. This one confuses me a bit. I'm gonna leave my torch, place it down in front of the corridor, and go through the door. I think this is correct. Yes, I believe this. So follow this round, and there will be two enemies in the room, so just be aware of that. Up the steps there is a door, we want to open it, and it is time. So turn the crank, and immediately you want to shift. Because that's a really short timer, that one. So you can see that the doors were all the way back into the wall, you couldn't see the doors at all. And as quickly as I was able to shift, look at how much the doors have already closed. So shift and hop down, and you see another crank here. You want to pull this crank. And that opens that gate right there. So we've opened that, so we don't have to shift through it. Because we want to bring the torch through here, once it's lit. Bring it to the end, and that's where we're going to use it. So once you shift, you can't... Oh, smack the mic, sorry. Readjusting. Once you shift, you can't have the mic. Oh, God, you can't have the torch in your hand, because you can't hold it in the spectral realm. And even if you have the Fire Reaver, once you shift, you lose the Fire Reaver. So, grab your torch from where you left it. Come down the corridor. Okay, so that's where we want the light, the torch, and the reaver, if you have the fire reaver. So don't forget, if you've been to the fire forge, you do not need a torch. It's just for the sake of the walkthrough that I'm showing you, both ways how you can do it. So, you may be wondering how to get your torch over there, because obviously, you might have guessed that you need to shift and these pillars would move, but what are you going to do with your torch? You are actually going to just throw it. And then shift. And there is a wraith in this room, so just, whoops, be aware that he's there. I have to shift back. You can't climb a ladder if you're in the spectral realm. And would you believe I've never missed that jump? Do it again, but better. What? There you go. Oh. Oh, no, wrong button. So there's the torch there, that's where it landed. And if you've been to the fire forge, just come up to the fire and press action, and now you've got your fire reaver. But if not, just pick up your torch and light your torch. Oop. Light the torch, there you go. Awesome. And now we can exit the way we came. Oh, that guy is right behind the door. What are you doing there? I like how he holds the stick out in front of him. Like, look, I got a stick. Look at my stick. So we're taking the torch through the gate we've opened, so now you understand that we couldn't have faced through here. Oh wow, go away. Well, I've just lost my reaver, so it's a good job I've got my torch. So just strike it. So, hop on. Throw that. Don't need it. I'm kind of glad this guy is here, because now I can actually do a demonstration. So this is the fire glyph. And it's a pretty awesome glyph that I have. Awesome. So don't forget your eyeball thing on the floor puts your energy straight back up. And now we have 14 energy. So our business here is done. So just leave the area, hop into the water. And if you did have your fire reaver, don't forget that that would be extinguished the moment you jump into the water. And we're just heading on out of here. Whoop. So up here, upstairs. And I'm actually going to just find the nearest warp gate to end the video. So I will end at the warp gate. So jumping out of the water, we are in a familiar place. If we come through the door, you might definitely know where we are. We are in Raziel's clan territory. Come up to fire, you get your fire reaver back. And here's the nearest warp gate. Open the door, please. So from here, I'm going to walk to Melkaya's clan territory to find some new items. And like I said before, the next video will be all about the pickups. There won't be any storyline, so just be warned. So going to Maltaya's territory. And thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Take it easy.